Welcome back to Croatia, to Osijek and to the Pampas shooting range. It's a beautiful day today, actually. Busy day for the juniors who are on centre stage. Busy for everybody. Time to get a bit of a snack. A lot of qualification going on in the sports hall away from this complex, and then this specially constructed arena outside the permanent structures. This is the sports hall where qualification goes on in the pistol and rifle, the 10 meter events. Everything else, qualification is here at the Pampas. And well, we've had a very entertaining two mixed team finals, the gold and bronze medal match in the rifle. It's a Russian bronze, an Italian silver, a Spanish gold. But as you can see, we're now concentrating on the pistol events. We have managed to get through qualification and find our four teams who will take place and take part in the bronze and gold medal matches. We start, of course, as always, with a bronze medal match, and that is Russia against Belarus. It's some of the athletes we saw in the individual events yesterday. Russia, well, they've been strong, haven't they, all the way through. This is Anastasia Shadak, 17 years of age. 10th in the individual events, are just outside the final yesterday. And next to her, Andrei Shilikov, he was 5th in the final, but just outside of the medals, 6th here 2 years ago. So certainly always there or thereabouts, the 20-year-old. For Belarus, Vasilisa Naumova, the 15-year-old who got individual silver yesterday, and another individual silver for Ivan Kazak, and he was just 1 year older at 16 than Naumova. Overseen, of course, this final with our officials. Our jury member in charge is from France, and of course we do have a chief range officer who will be calling the athletes to account. And Ferencsák was busy yesterday, and Slovenia is busy here today as well. So the gold medal match between Italy and Belarus to come, but Belarus also, this is Belarus team 2 in this bronze medal match. So it is possible that Belarus could have two teams on the podium. Gunnar, mascot, is here and enjoying the warm conditions, I'm sure, inside this hall. The Kuna is a bit like a ferret, I was told yesterday, but a bit bigger and fiercer. Just so you know, it's also the name of the currency here in Croatia. Well, we're just waiting to get underway. A reminder of how it works. It's the first to 16 points. Each team member takes a shot. They have 50 seconds to get that target away. The highest combined score scores 2 points. If tied, a point apiece. And if we get to a situation where we are tied at 16, then one additional shot to decide. Clock's counting down. We are ready to go with our first round of targets here. Who will take an early advantage? 9-9 from Naumova. 9-6, 9-8 from Shadak and Shilikov. Oh, and a 8-7 from Kazak, who took his time. So the Belarus athletes not able to help them to 2 points. It is Russia who take first blood here.
For the next competition,
Shadak, very focused. Of course, our scoring here will be a little more variable than we did see with the air rifle. So excellent scores there, but of course they do have the advantage of specialised clothing, the stiffened canvas suits and the gloves, just to help them steady themselves. No such thing here. You can see some athletes trying to lock the elbow in a really old position for most people. And it's 2-2, 0.2 the difference, a 10 from Kazak helping matters, and the 9-6 just edging the 9-4 from Shadak. So, 2 apiece. Will it be a nip and tuck bronze medal here? been a busy old day again. The Croatian army helping to construct and make sure everything is running smoothly. We thank them for their efforts and our organizing committee. Andrei Chilikov. Sort the breathing, slow the heart rate down. 10-3, excellent. And the 20-year-old. Bit of a veteran. 9.8 from Shadak. So it all comes down to Kozak, who for Belarus is going to have to shoot really well. Here it's not enough, and Russia go into a 4-2 lead.
Now the Russian team has 4 points, Belarus has 2 points.
Well, Belarus have been confident enough to pull back in the early stages. You see just how bespoke these pistols are. Although Naumova and Shadak have had moments where they've not been happy with how they've been shooting. 4-2 then to the Russians. Here's our next series. Nine, nine and a 10 from the Russians. Oh, a 10-2 from Naumova. That's better. It's all down once again to Ivan Kozak, the silver medalist yesterday, looking for a bronze here. That'd be a nice haul to take home. And he takes his time and it's not really paid dividends. 8.9, and so now it's a 6-point advantage to Russia. Belarus, of course, guaranteed at least a silver there in the final, the gold medal match with Italy. Margarita Vicario looking for a second gold medal of these European Championships. Oh, Ivan Kozak take his time yet again. Here's Naumova, who's shot some excellent targets at that moment. The team are 2 points behind. 9-5, not brilliant, but not a disaster because Shadak shot a 7.9 and a 10 from Kozak. That's better from him, and Belarus pull it back to within 2 points.
There's
Kozak, the Belarus team, allowed 5 supports team staff here in the final tour. Because of COVID, of course, just trying to keep the numbers down. Vasily is Naumova. And here's Ivan Kozak, Belarus team. Chilikov with a 9-9. Shadak with a 9-5. It's certainly doable for Belarus, who've taken their time, but use it wisely in a 10-4 from Kozak. Make sure it's 6 apiece.
2 points.
Well, coming back from 6-2. Excellent work. Got a lot more finals to go. Junior finals through today, this Sunday, first Sunday of these championships. Hope you can stay with us. We've got a lot to get in. Biggest competition of any sport before Tokyo, this European Championships, and all 60 finals being streamed by the IWSF on the internet. Love to have your feedback on how we're doing. Got some television broadcasts amongst those as well. 10 and a 9-8 from Russia, who get their shots way early. That's great from Belarus, though, who just edge into the lead for the first time. Both those targets in the tens. And all of a sudden, the pressure is now on the Russian team. These are the Belarus pair who have come back from a 4-point deficit to be 2 points ahead. First team event ever in the European Championships. Enjoying them. The athletes certainly do, means there's more chance for them to be involved in finals and in competition generally. Can Russia pull back? 10-3 from Chilikov is a decent target, but a 10-6 from Kazakh and a 9-9 is enough from Naumova to make sure that Belarus now have a comfortable lead. Well, they were 6-2 down. They've taken the last 8 points. And remember, there is a possibility of a timeout being called by the coaches. Let's see what the next series brings. I think if it goes to 12-6, we might see that timeout being called, but we'll just see what the coach wants to do. Chidak and Chilikov with a little bit of work to do. Naumova and Kazak all of a sudden looking confident. 10-4 from Naumova and a 9-7. And still enough. Still enough, because both the Russian athletes were in the early nines. Well, from 6-2 up to 12-6 down. What can Russia do here? They've got to dig deep. 17, 20 years of age. It's not as if they can dig in. Call upon lots of finals experience, but this is the sort of thing that will strengthen whatever happens. Never have too much experience, can you? Andrei Chilikov hoping for better in this series. That's lovely. 9-10-4 and an 8-8. Oh, that gives the Belarus team a chance to wrap this up. It has to be solid though from Kazakh. Taking his time, there's still, what, 20 seconds on the clock. Everyone else sits and waits. What is it? It's a 10-3, and it was worth the wait. 6-14, Belarus, what a comeback. They have absolutely roared back in this bronze medal match. So they can wrap it up in this next series. They have taken the last 12 points without response. That is astonishing. We thought it would be a tight one, but at the moment, Russia really in a spot of bother here. What can Chidak and Chilikov do? Crowd sense that this might be the end game. 9-2 from Chilikov. Oh, a 10-5 from Chidak gives him a fighting chance. Now it's all down to Naumova. Well, she's done it. It was a 9-9. It wasn't great, but it was a 0.3 difference. And Belarus take it by 16 points to 6, having scored the last 14 points in a row. Astonishing. And Belarus now guaranteed 2 medals in this competition. Well, you have to feel for the Russians, who were 6-2 up and looking like they might go all the way very quickly, but all of a sudden the Belarus team dug deep and it is them who will take the bronze medal. Chidak and Chilikov will have to settle for fourth, but an excellent display by a very strong Belarus team. Naumova, Kazakh, with a great come-from-behind win, take the bronze medal.
And please to the line. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome our athletes in 10 meters, athletes of mixing gold and match. One big applause for our athletes. Take your positions. Preparation and cycling time. Start.
This is the preparation for the gold medal match. Sighting shots going on, and then we will be into the meat of it. So sighting shots, and then the competition begins.
The combined score of the one shot of both team members that is better brings the team 2 points. If both teams have the same score in one shot, both teams win 1 point. The team that first reaches 16 points wins the gold medal match.
Hello everybody, we are back in action here at the Pampas shooting range. Nice sunny day. We've had a bit of rain, a bit more than I think the locals were expecting in the last few days, seeing what the forecast was saying, but beautiful sunshine. Along the way, the skeet shooters are getting ready for their competition. We are well underway with the junior competition. Individual competitions yesterday, team competitions today. Qualification taking place in the hall away from the Pampas shooting range. The organisers make sure that COVID regulations are adhered to. It was a long and arduous qualification, always is. A marathon, not a sprint, of course. Italy just missing out with a second team into the finals. They were just 1 point away from Belarus, who have just come from behind to clinch the bronze medal.
Ladies and gentlemen, the organizing committee of the European Championship.
This, though, is the gold medal match, and it is Italy against Belarus, the second Belarus team. After the first Belarus team, Belarus number two, took the bronze medal. This is Belarus number one. But first of all, we have to say hello to the Italian team. And this is Margherita Vaccario, who won the individual gold yesterday. So can she take 2 gold medals home to Italy? Well, next to her is somebody who matched those achievements, Federico Maldini. He got the individual gold as well as a bronze at the last European Championships. So the coach must be very confident that they can do a job here, 19 or 20 years of age. And this is 15-year-old Sandra Petrova. And next to her, the 18-year-old Lyle Dizemesh. Their coach hoping for gold here as well. She's been busy. The Belarus team have been busy as well. We've enjoyed seeing them succeeding. That's our jury member in charge. Our chief range officer remains the same as we've seen throughout the first opening days of this competition. There he is, our Slovenian boss, who will talk us through the athletes and what they have to do. So Italy won against Belarus team number one. That's for the gold medal match. Remember, the first to 16 points. Everyone shoots, and whoever gets the highest total will get the 2 points. A tie, a point apiece, of course. And if we're tied at 16 points, we have an additional shot to decide who will take the gold medal. It's quite warm in here now. It was chilly yesterday. The weather outside wasn't great, but the temperature is what, around 25, 26 outside, and it's just getting a little bit warm in here. Whether that will affect the athletes at all remains to be seen. Just waiting for our first series to get underway. Biggest competition in any sport before Tokyo. We are covering everything. I hope you will enjoy it with us. We do have some non-European athletes competing for the minimum qualification score. They need that if they are going to go to the Olympic Games. So there is a set score for all these different disciplines. So I did see some Indian shooters here yesterday. But they won't be involved if they're not from Europe in the finals, that's for sure. So Belarus with the first 2 points. Nice 10.3 from Dzemesh.
For the next competition shot,
Lou. Ladislav Dzemesh starting well. Italy looking for yet another gold. These two athletes with the individual gold in pistol. There was another gold for them in the rifle disciplines. Managed a silver in the air rifle mixed team. Ten again from Dzemesh, but it's not enough. A 10-3 from Vicario. There's enough just to edge it by 0.1. So it is 2 points apiece.
The
teams are now tied. Battle for gold. Astonishing bronze medal match. Russia 6-2 up against Belarus, only to lose 16-6. What a comeback. 49 answer points from Belarus. Just goes to prove that you're never out until the 16-point barrier has been broken. Remember, the coaches watching in the background have a timeout should they need it. These four athletes seem to be athletes who like to just take their time. Oh, a 10.8 for Maldini. And that is excellent. 10.7 from Vicario. Goodness me, only dropping a fraction of a point there. It was good shooting from Belarus, but it just wasn't enough. So Italy into the lead, 4-2. That's the safety that you have to have in at all times, apart from during competition. You will get into all sorts of bother if you don't have that in. Even when you're just getting yourself ready, has to be in until you start, you're ready to start firing the pellets from these bespoke pistols. Not the cheapest you'll ever see. And at this level, you need to have something that will serve you well. 10-1 from Pietrova, but not enough because Maldini comes through again with a 10.3. And all of a sudden, it's Italy who are looking good at 6-2. The Belarus coach holding her timeout in her pocket for the time being. So another series here. 50 seconds to get these shots away. They can see the clock if they want to. It's bright and red and right in front of them, but they'll be concentrating on that target. Oh, a 9-5 from Maldini. What's this from Dzemesh? A 9-2. Well, Vicario only needed a 9-8. That was enough to take it by quite some distance. An 8-9 from Pietrova wasn't helpful for the Belarus team. So from being ahead early on, they now find themselves in trouble at 8-2. These pistols are checked by the officials to make sure there's enough compressed air in there, but not too much. Make sure it's the right weight. of pre-qualification checks needed, but now we're down to the business in hand. Italy halfway to the 16 they need, but it's a solid start from the Belarus team. 10-2 and a 10-3, and that's enough to bring them back to within four. That'll make them feel a whole lot better. Italians, there's Maldini, who was very good yesterday. A second European Championship junior gold, junior medal for him. He now has a bronze and a gold from the last couple of editions. Here we go then, there's the four athletes. Belarus on the right-hand side. They all take their time, don't they? In the bronze medal match, it was three out of four who shot very quickly. 10-4 from Dezemesh. And, well, a 9-5 was enough. Half a point in it. And all of a sudden, it's getting tight again. Well, certainly bit of a gap earlier on, but this is the beauty of this competition. These athletes know it's not over. They can put a run together, and it's kind of what tends to happen once you start hitting well. You get a bit of confidence, and away you go. Dezemesh, 18-year-old. It's a lot, isn't it, for our teenagers. 10-5 from Pietrova, and that is enough, despite the 10-6 from Vicario, to see them level at 8-8. So, halfway, both of these teams now, to the 16 they need. Here in Osijek, easterly, city in Croatia, where Drava, big river flowing slowly through on one side of the city. So what, 25 kilometers upstream from where it meets the Danube, beautiful part of the world. That's better from Belarus. Wow, now they are starting to motor from being 6-2 down. And now 10-8 up. Will the Italian coach decide that a timeout is needed? Such a new competition, one of those that the IWSF have brought in. I think sometimes the coaches forget they have that power to just talk to their athletes. It's going to be a tight one, isn't it? Ahead in the opening stages. Belarus now hauling themselves back into contention. Oh, and it's good from both the Belarus athletes. Look at that, both decent tens. It's good from Maldini. 9-9's no disgrace, but it's not enough in this round. And Belarus extend their lead. 12-8. 4 points away from the gold medal. Well, Italy couldn't do anything but get goals yesterday. They've had to settle for silver in the mixed team air rifle competition, beaten by Spain. And will they have to settle for silver here? Vicario in the box there. She's normally the last, one of the last athletes to shoot. A 9-8 from her, and well, again, two really strong tens from the Belarus athletes, and they are now on the cusp of the gold medal. But again, a bit like the bronze medal matches, it come from behind, not quite as pronounced. But Federico Maldini and Margherita Vicario have to dig in and do something here. By no means over, but they can afford no more mistakes here, no more poor scores. It's a really tough environment, the finals hall. So can Belarus wrap it up here? That's all right, but not spectacular from Mardini. 10-4, that's good from Vicario, but it's all on Pietrova, and an 8-8 means that they will have to carry on their quest for the gold. Italy pull one back. 10-14, the score. Italy hanging in there. It's tense out there on the finals field. It's hot as well. They'll be feeling the heat, that's for sure. Belarus. Just think about Alexandra Pietrova. Just 15 years of age. Didn't make the finals yesterday individually, but a gold here would certainly make up for it, I'm sure. Maldini, pressure on the Italian. 10-2, that's not a bad marker. And a 9-5 from Pietrova and a 9-3 from Dzemesh. Vicario, it's in her hands, and it's 12-14. The pendulum continues to swing one way and then the other. Remember, they were 12-8 down, was it 14-8 then as well? No timeouts from our coaches as of yet. Well, this will be a tense one. If it becomes 14-14, won't it? I think it's tense enough as it is. Belarus, here's the 15-year-old. Pietrova, calm beyond her years. That's what she's trained for, though. Day in, day out, year in, year out. 10-4 from Dzemesh, she's a good one. All hangs on Vicario, and 9-5 isn't enough, and it's Belarus who will take the gold medal by 16 points to 12. Italy, a second silver of the morning. Excellent work from both these sets of athletes. Italy looked they were going to take it to the last series, but in the end, Belarus dug in. That 10-4 from Dzemesh meant that the two of them can celebrate and join with the mascot. That's a gold medal. They look more exhausted than delighted, but I'm sure they are underneath. And more medals. It was gold for both these Italian athletes yesterday. Today, it's silver. Well, Belarus have been outstanding, the team, throughout the first 2 days. Italy, of course, always a powerhouse, and they have been excellent as well. Just didn't happen for them. They get the silver. And Belarus, both Belarus teams, of course, getting the podium places. Belarus 2. With the bronze, Italy taking the silver, and it's Belarus 1 who take the gold. Congratulations to Vasilia Anomova and Ivan Kazak.